This is Motovore, I'm Tushar, and we're glamping again, this time in Jaisalmer with the new updated Ford Endeavour. Also, I don't know how to park on sand. I'm going to be honest, I am a super fanboy of the Ford Endeavour. I've driven it a bunch of times. I've driven the old 2.2 automatic, I've driven the 3.2 automatic, and I'm driving the 3.2 automatic today in the updated 2019, guys. It's just a really great vehicle to drive. It's excellent for family outings. It's excellent for long road trips because the suspension is plush, the engine is quite adequate for this kind of vehicle. It's got 470 Newton meters of torque, and I understand that you can chip it to get quite a bit more. It's just a great practical vehicle. There's just so much space. All right, hopefully you can see what I mean about space with this wide shot at the back. We open the hatch and this is what the boot looks like. There's a whole bunch of our photography stuff and miscellaneous luggage right there for three people, and just look at the amount of space there, and understand that there's a third row of seats right here which we flipped down. This is the boot with two rows of seats, the front and the back, and there's a third one here. If you flip the second row down, you have an absolutely flat 7 feet of space. This is a camper with both those seats folded down. It's crazy. There's just so much flat cargo space. Ford is pegging it at, I think, about 2100 liters, which is phenomenal. The Endeavour has so much space that this would actually qualify as a 1BHK in Mumbai. It has so much space that dealers actually have to register with the Real Estate Regulatory Authority and sell by carpet area. I've been sitting on that joke for at least a couple of years, and now that that's out of the way, I can actually tell you what's new in the 2019 Ford Endeavour.
There's this new design of alloy wheels. These are 18-inch rims. They are dual tone. I'm going to refrain from calling them diamond cut because I don't like diamond cut. These look nice.
This is not entirely new, it was there in the previous system, but this is the relatively new Ford Sync 3 system. It's a newish infotainment system and it's really good. Nice capacitive touchscreen, has Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. It's only a little bit irritating to start CarPlay or Android Auto, but in general, it's nice, responsive, fairly simple to use. I think this is one of the better infotainment systems in cars today. Finally, the front passenger also gets powered seat control so that he doesn't need to pull himself fore and aft like a gareeb.
There's also a new skid plate up front. Captain Vasu, tere heart toot gaya kya?
Cash ki goniya utha utha ke haan, mere heart toot gaya.
Oh, fancy.
So apart from those features that you can see, there's also stuff that you can't see. For example, the top model of the Endeavour now gets 7 airbags. There's also a start-stop button instead of just cranking the key, because that one you can see. Now, if you've seen video reviews of the old Ford Endeavour, then you've basically seen the review of this one, because mechanically, the old one and the new one are identical. There is no change. It's still got a 200 PS motor with 470 Newton meters of torque. It's still all-wheel drive, it's still got terrain management systems, it's still got the sunroof, everything. But you haven't seen a review from me, so here goes. I'm a total Endeavour fanboy. I really like it because despite the fact that it's an absolute behemoth, I think it's one of the largest, or it is the largest vehicle in its category. It's actually larger than the Toyota Fortuner, and that's a pretty big vehicle. It's amazingly easy to drive. The steering is so light. You can actually drive the Endeavour as big as it is in the city. I drove it all through Pune city, and if you know anything about Pune, you know that their traffic rules are, well, they're just guidelines really. Nobody really cares. Despite that, I was all over the city for a great many days, and it was just so easy to drive. Market areas, open highways, just didn't matter. It was great. And of course, the main thing about the Endeavour has to be the space. There's no getting around it. It really is a 1BHK. That 7 feet of flat space, it's crazy. I have dogs, or a dog anyway. I have borrowed dogs. And we go to trips. We go take them out. And it's always a pleasure to have a nice, voluminous car to take them in. You know, it's just more comfortable. The leather seats are nice. They're very supportive. They're very good. The ride quality is really plush. The last long trip I did with the Endeavour was, I think, a couple of months ago. I drove it from Mumbai to Goa and back. It was a bit of a customer drive that Ford was doing. Everybody came with their families, four people, five people, kids, and it it was just wonderful, despite the long days of driving. It's such a capable vehicle and yet remains very accessible to the average user. Now this time, for the 2019 model press drive, we went to Jaisalmer. In Jaisalmer, we were at the sand dunes and we were basically going dune bashing. It just glides up sand. It's like a desert ship, really. Put five people in there, or seven people for that matter, since it's a three row, and just float through sand. It's just really easy to do slightly more adventurous things. Coming to the comfort, the plush ride quality is definitely a plus. Now, this is not a vehicle, especially considering how big it is, this is not a vehicle you're going to want to chuck around corners and up ghats and things like that. You can do that, it's going to be a little bit matang matang. Perfectly acceptable compromise for the level of comfort that it offers. I think we have to give the air conditioning its due, because in order to cool a 1 BHK, it will take a sizable amount of compressor power, and Endeavour does a very decent job. It works fine, no complaints about the AC. Let's talk about the engine and the transmission. Now the transmission is a 6-speed auto and it's a torque converter, which means that it's really nice and smooth, but by nature of it being a 6-speed auto, it is a little bit old. Today you've got 7, 8 and 9 speeds on competing vehicles. While numerically it's going to make you feel like a little bit old, in practice it really doesn't matter. It's worth mentioning that the Endeavour has active noise cancellation in the cabin. Not too many vehicles of any price bracket actually have this feature. It uses microphones internally to use its own speakers to cancel out the noises that are coming from the outside. So basically, to put it simplistically, if the sound wave is like this, it's going to play a sound wave like that so that it cancels out, and it works surprisingly well. It almost makes you feel like you want to pop your ears, kind of like you're changing altitude in an airplane. It provides a level of comfort and refinement that you wouldn't expect in such a huge and fairly rough and tough vehicle. Talking about rough and tough, the ground clearance is substantial. I really don't think you're going to be scraping this anywhere. However, it is a fairly long wheelbase vehicle, so if you're going to be clambering over sharp rocks and things like that, you might want to be careful. Now, despite looking fairly plain from the inside, the Endeavour did have quite a large number of features, and that continues with the new one, particularly the top model. For example, the rear tailgate was always motorized, but now it's got a hands-free feature, so you know, you do the whole kicky thing and the thing opens up, and then you press a button to close it down again. You also have a motorized third row of seats, so you can basically go into the boot and press a button and the third row will flip forward or flip back as you require. In terms of price, now the range is a little bit wide because you've only got three models, so you've got fairly cheap and then you've got fairly expensive. Also, Ford is stressing a really low cost of ownership. They've got some ridiculously low amount of money that you need to spend over a 1 lakh kilometer lifetime with this car. It's really quite surprising for something this premium. So really, that's my review of the new Ford Endeavour. Not too many changes, but I think it's still fairly decent value for what it offers. It's a very capable and very large vehicle. My only problem with it is I can't afford a 1 BHK in Mumbai. I can't afford a Ford Endeavour.